There are lots of small and big problems that can go wrong with your rigs in the rigging process. Some of them are the problems for the modeling and can be fixed by retopology or modeling your model in a different way, but some of them fixed in the rigging process. There are a lot of problems. We are not going to deep dive into all of them. We're going to cover the most major and common problems that you're going to face during your rigging process. To be specific, four of the most common problems that almost everyone faced before or gonna face during the rigging process. Number one. The first problem occurs when you're going to scale your skeleton to the model and just generate your rig. As you can see, the rig is much smaller than the skeleton and it should be the size of the skeleton and your model. This happens because you're scaling your rig, and as you can see, the scale is 2.560. It is not the one. The scale should be 1. To fix this problem, simply click your rig, press Ctrl plus A and apply the scale. You can also apply all transforms. It works the same. As you can see, the scale is all 1 and it's gonna generate the rig according to the size of the skeleton. I regenerate the rig, and as you can see, the rig is identical to the skeleton. Number two. The next problem is bending the joint in the wrong way. I select my rig, go to the pose mode, and move my leg. As you can see, the leg is bending in the wrong way. It should bend in the forward position, but it's going sideways. To fix this problem, go back to your metric skeleton, and in the side view, as you can see, it's almost identically straight, and the rig don't know which is the right way to bend your model. To guide the rig and fix this problem, select your skeleton, go to the edit, and move slightly to the forward. It is the way the knee bends. And if you have the same problem with the elbow, just move it slightly backward in the elbow position. As you can see, if I regenerate the rig, let's hide the metric, select the rig, go to the pose mode, move my leg, it's almost fixed. But to make sure it does not go sideways, bring up my metal rig, select it, go to the pose mode, select the upper limb, go to the bone, and in the options, and remember, if you're not in the pose mode, this option will not appear to you. If I select the object mode or edit mode, I don't have the options. You should be in the pose mode. Select the upper limb, and in the rotation axis, select the X manual. I do the same for the other one, and generate the rig again. Hide the metal rig, and this way we make sure that always it's going to rotate in the x-axis, and with the skeleton bending slightly forward, it means that the knee should bend in that position. Number three. The next problem is an unusual deformation of your model when you're moving a bone. For example, if I select my rig, go to the pose mode, and move my head bone, it should control the whole head. As you can see, if I move it, the head starts to deform because the influence of this bone on the head is not complete. And here, if I move my right foot, the left foot also comes with the right foot. This is actually a wake painting problem. To solve this problem, select your model and go to the wake paint. Find the skeleton responsible for moving or controlling that part. For example, spine 006 is controlling the head. You can check it with selecting each spine to see where they have influence. And as you can see here, this spine should have full control on the head. Full control means the red areas. Blue areas means zero control, and everything in between is a percentage between 0 and 100% control. I put the weight on 1 and paint the head to fully red. It means this bone will have full influence on the red areas. And it fixed the deformation problem. Let's check it. Select the rig, go to the pose mode, move the desired bone, and as you can see, the head doesn't deform. It is something that you should put time on it and experiment with different type of weights between 0 and 100 in order to learn how to weight paint correctly for animations. But as you can see, the problem is fixed. It is what we want. Now the next problem is moving the left foot with the right foot. To fix that, select your model, go to the weight paint, find the right foot bone from the vertex groups in the data, foot right. As you can see, it controls the right foot, also have a lot influence on the left foot. Put the weight on 0, paint the left foot with blue. It means the right foot bone should not control anything on the left foot. Let's check it again. Go to the object mode, select the rig, go to the pose mode, move my right foot. As you can see, it has a little bit of influence on the toes on the left foot. Let's check it again. select my model, go to the bait paint, and with the strength of 1 and weight of 0, I paint the toes again. It should be fixed now. Go to the object mode, select the rig, go to the pose mode, move my right foot, and as you can see, it has zero influence on the left foot. Number 4. Next problem happens when you have a stationary prop or piece of clothes on your character that should not deform with other parts of your body. For example, here I have a revolver, the side of my character, and revolver itself should not deform with the body. It should move with the hip, that's right, but it should not deform. If I go to the pose mode, move the hip, as you can see, the revolver will deform. And if I move the hand, the revolver deforms also. Fix this problem, go to the object mode, select the revolver, go to the modifiers, and remove the armature. Now select the revolver, select the rig, go to the pose mode, and select the rig that is gonna responsible for moving the revolver. For example, the rig of the hip. Press Ctrl P, and instead of automatic weights, select bone. If I move the rig now, you can see the revolver will also move with the bone. If I move the hand, the revolver stays. It's because the revolver is parented to the hip bone. It's useful for the stationary props. Of course, if you're going to use this weapon to draw the weapon or to shoot with it, you need to have a separated rig for the weapon. But that's for another course, for another time. For now, this method is usable for stationary props. For example, for something attaching to your hand, to your hip, to your leg, but should not deform like an organic body. That's it for this video. If you like the video, please hit the like and subscribe to the channel. More videos and tutorials like this are gonna upload it soon. Take care, have a good day, and bye bye.